Technicolor's original goal was full-spectrum color photography for motion picture screens. Technicolor achieved their goal by completely redesigning the camera that they had been using in the 20s. The new camera was designed by J.A. Ball, Technicolor's technical director in the early 30s. The cameras were manufactured by the Mitchell Camera Corporation in Glendale, California, and remained in commercial use from 1932 until 1954. Unlike the two-color system, which recorded the film on one strip of black and white negative, this new camera ran three black and white negatives simultaneously, and that is why it is known as three-strip Technicolor. The magazine on top of the camera, which is that part that looks like the Mickey Mouse ears, was triple the width of a normal black and white camera because it contained each roll of negative to capture your red, green, and blue records. Inside the camera, directly behind the lens, was the beam-splitting prism. This had a gold-flecked, semi-transparent mirror in its center, which allowed half the light to go directly through to the green record, and the other half to be reflected 90 degrees onto two film strips in bipack. The bipack was two negative films sandwiched together, emulsion to emulsion in the gate. The front film was the blue record, and on its emulsion was a red dye which acted like the filter for the red record directly behind. When shooting in Technicolor, you weren't just getting the camera. You rented from Technicolor an entire package, which included the camera, a camera crew with three assistants, the film, the processing, and a Technicolor color consultant. To dampen the sound, the Technicolor camera was enclosed in an enormous box known as a blimp. Made of metal with soundproofing material on the inside, it was 4 feet high, 2 feet wide, and 4 feet long, which brought the camera up to a weight of about 400 to 500 pounds. The blimp made the camera very unwieldy, which limited its mobility and caused cinematographers to become very creative in their filmmaking. The blimp was so large that it was referred to by English cinematographers as the Enchanted Cottage. 29 three-strip cameras were manufactured between 1933 and 1950 for live-action photography. An additional three cameras were manufactured for animation, and another three were made for high-speed photography for slow motion effects. In England, because the demand for Technicolor was not as high as it was in the American studios, only four cameras were made. For his remarkable achievement of inventing the three-color camera, J.A. Ball won a special Academy Award in 1938 for his contribution to the advancement of color and motion picture photography.